Been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and
Officially, welcome to Athletic Stretch. My name is Lynne. For those of you who have just joined, I do plan on using a yoga block at some point in today's class as an option, and then also sliders. And you can do the entire workout class without any additional equipment. A mat would be a nice option. So my goal today is to focus a little bit more on the upper body. We'll of course get into the hips and lower body a little bit, but we're going to have a larger emphasis on the upper body, the shoulder region, the thoracic spine, in our 30 minutes. So we'll go ahead and find our way in. A lot of this will be on the mat today. We'll start in a tabletop position and we'll work on setting that up first. Hands under the shoulders with fingers spread wide and just turn the fingertips out just a little bit. Knees directly below the hips, flexing the toes towards the shins. And from here, you can start with a scap push-up where you squeeze your shoulder blades and press them apart, keeping the arms long. Now you have the option to stay there or take this into shoulder rolls where we actually try to find some circular movement in the shoulder joint from this tabletop position. Arms stay long in whichever variation you're in. And if you're doing the circles, go ahead and try to reverse that. Might take a little bit of thought and coordination. But I'm not the kind of person that it was. She said, where'd she want? Spending a few more seconds here before we come to a half kneeling position. Let's go ahead and change. Coming up to half kneeling, so one leg will come out in front, back leg will stay down, we'll bring hands out in front, and then we'll exhale and open up one direction, and then close, and then open up the other direction. Eyes following the moving hand, finding some rotation in the trunk. Let's do one more to each side. Bring the hands back down. Now the arm on the same side as the lead leg. Let's bring it up overhead. Make a fist and start doing some shoulder circles, coming down just the outside of the hip and then reversing it, allowing the shoulder to move in the joint. Now you can stay right here or you can come up and hold in an elevated or a hovered split squat. Wherever you're at, you're here for another 10. Keeping the arm as straight as possible. And let's change. Switch out the legs first. Both arms come out in front. We'll rotate open, eyes following the moving arm. We'll close again. Both directions. Oh, you're looking good, Thursday. Let's get one more to each side. Now on side two, let's bring the arm up overhead. So same side as the lead leg. Make a fist, draw it down and back. And a circular motion, once you get to the outside of the hip, reverse it. And you can stay right there or come up into that split squat position. Back leg's still bent, thinking about pulling the feet together. As the arm works through that rotation, you get about 10 more seconds here, wherever you're at. One more each direction. Return to our tabletop, hands come down, feet step back. Now we'll step 1 foot forward as far as you can, keeping the sole of the foot flat to the floor. Back knee drops down, elbow comes down to the inside of the ankle or your best variation of that. And then you add some rotation here. Turning towards the lead leg.
Dang. Once I get them back in my side.
Two more here.
Telling me now wasn't all right. I'm just seeing something.
And then we change. You can allow the back knee to drop down. Elbow to the inside of the ankle or the arch of the foot, rotating towards the lead leg. Your range of motion might look different than mine or your neighbor's. Your movements throughout class might look a little bit different than mine and your neighbor's. And that would be expected. We all have some things that we're working through, and we're all here to try to maximize our body's ability to move the way that it was designed. Let's get one more here. Plant both hands. Come up to your high plank position. Now you can come down onto your forearms. Elbows right underneath the shoulders. You need to drop to your knees here. That's a nice modified plank option. Wherever you can stay and hold for the next 30 seconds, hold your low plank. Thinking about pulling the knees and the toes closer to the elbows, driving the elbows back down towards the hips. Upper back presses towards the ceiling. Chin stays out of the chest. Beautiful flanks Thursday. 10 more seconds here. Hollow out the belly. In 2, 1, bring it down. We're gonna come down onto our bellies. Go ahead and have your sliders nearby. We have 2 rounds. The first one, we're going to bring the head down so it can either rest on the mat, a block, whatever you need here. We're going to take one hand, go thumbs up position. And we're going to lift the hand, bring it around so that the palm's facing the ceiling. Set it down in the small of the back. And then lift it up again and bring it back around. Sticking with the same side, let's do that a few more times. Again, moving slowly here. Last time through. And then we'll take it to side 2. Thumbs up position on side 2. Allow the arm to rotate as you bring the knuckles to the small of the back. Allow the hand to rest and then lift the elbow and rotate it back through. Look for about 2 more on this side.
I ain't got too much time to spend.
And 1 more before we make a change.
To show how much.
Go ahead and bring the hands back in underneath the shoulders. We'll come up to a tabletop position. Here's where we're headed. We'll use our sliders. We'll place them underneath our feet.
Good luck.
We'll start in a tabletop position. Walk our feet out to a high plank and then start with knee tucks, pulling the knees in and pressing them away. Now, if you don't have sliders today, and you're just using the floor, you're going to go to a pike and reach back towards the opposite toe, alternating. So let's go ahead and set it up. Pull the knees in using the core and the hip flexors and press away.
Yeah.
Oh, pressing the floor away. Join me when you're ready. And if you're without sliders, you're doing that pike with a reach back. Actively pressing the floor away in whichever variation you're in. You get 10 more seconds here.
I'm a fool, but they'll think I'm dying.
In 2, 1, set it down. Find your belly again. We'll return to our swimmers. You can stick with single side just like we did before. Option this time, not a better option, just another option. You could do both at the same time. Lift, rotate, and bring the knuckles to the small of the back. You might find that it changes your available range of motion to do both of them together. So stick with the variation that works for you. Your hip points are still on the floor. Your feet are still on the floor.
Yeah.
And you're letting the shoulder joint just move each part of the movement. If you need to switch sides, do that now. Get about 10 more seconds here. In 5, you change. And go ahead and plant your hands under your shoulders. Press up to your tabletop. Get set up for your knee tucks or your press backs. Now, option with your sliders, instead of a knee tuck, you could take it to a pike. So set up, maybe try the knee tuck, maybe try the pike, and join me when you're ready. Using again your core, your hip flexors, your shoulder stability. And if you are without a slider option, hips go high, you reach towards the toes. Doesn't matter if you're able to touch them or not. The intention is to get closer. You get about 10 more seconds here. Wherever you're at, try to get 2 more. Excellent. Take a break. Grab some water if you'd like. Nice job. Here's where we're headed. We have a side plank variation coming up. We have some shoulder work and some additional core work. So, your very basic side plank is going to be stack the shoulders, chin stays out of the chest. Bottom knee can stay down, you can lift the hips. You could choose to stay right there. Another option is to drop the hips and lift up. We'll start with those in the first round. So let's go ahead and start, set up in your side plank. Shoulders right above the elbow. Shoulders are stacked, chins out of the chest. Keeping the knee down to start. You can hold right here. Another option is to lift and lower. Another progression would be to take both feet long. I would recommend keeping the feet staggered and scissored, so it's less pressure on the spine. In 5, we change. In 2, 1, switch sides. Whichever variation you took on side 1, make sure you repeat it on side 2. So again, you can start with that modified plank. Maybe both feet extended. I'll give you other options in the upcoming rounds. Doing your best to not roll the shoulder forward or tuck the chin. Five more seconds here. In 2, 1, we change. Taking our sliders again as an option. We'll start on our knees, kind of that modified plank, high plank position. And we're just going to work on sliding out with control, lowering down, and then just bringing the arms back in, coming back up and doing it again. If you're without the sliders, you're going to walk your hands out as far as you can, lower down, and again, come back up. When you're ready, you begin. Lots of core and shoulder stability here. Doesn't matter how you come back up. Doesn't need to be a push-up. You're feeling really strong. You could try it from your toes. I'm not there yet. Finding a few more here. Last one. When you finish that last one, make your way to your backside. We'll start with knees bent. You could keep them there. Hands to the outside of the hips or underneath the tailbone if you find that supports your low back better. Now option, straighten the legs a little bit and then lower one leg down and use the core and the hip flexor to raise it back up. You can keep the knee bent and reach the heel towards the floor as a nice option. A little bit more of a challenge, lift up the shoulder blades and work on lowering. The straighter the legs are, the more challenge you'll have. The small of the back needs to be pressed into the floor. Belly button drives down towards the spine. One more on each side, wherever you're at. Excellent, the feet can come down. And we go through it again, finding your side plank first. Setting up just as you did before. Another option here that you could consider is to reach the top arm forward and the left leg back, pull them back in. Elbow and knee come to touch or with that intention. So the option is to hold, lift and lower the hips, or add this reach with maybe just the upper body. You'll find a little bit of rotation here. Spending a few more seconds in 2, 1, we change, side two. Now, whichever variation was on side one is repeated on side two. Once you set it up, clock starts now. You begin when you're ready. Good controlled movements. Again, if you're reaching forward and one leg is going back, you're getting a little bit of rotation through the trunk. Core remains tight. In 2, 1, set it down. We come to our knees, either with your gliders or without. We're going to come out as far as we can until we can't hold anymore. We lower down and start it over. You begin when you're ready. Maybe seeing 4 to 6 reps here. Getting good control and stability in the shoulders. In the core, chin stays out of the chest. Really nice effort, team. You get about 10 more seconds, maybe 1 or 2 more. Finish the one that you're on, and then we'll meet on our backside. Nice work. Returning to your backside. Again, legs can be bent or straight. You have a better idea here in the second round. Hands can go underneath the tailbone if needed. And then lower down, lift back up, slow and controlled, using your core, your hip flexors, keeping space between your chin and your chest.
Oh no. See you walking around like it's a funeral. Not so serious, girl, why don't be cold? We just get
about 10 more seconds here, and then we move into your official stretch.
Waste time with the masterpiece, the waste time with the masterpiece.
You last one.
You should be lonely.
Set the feet down. Nice job. From here, we'll go ahead and flip over into our tabletop position.
Start living dangerously.
Finding some longer held stretches. We start in tabletop, just like we started class. We'll flip the left palm up, thread it through the right side, ear to the floor, hips stay high. Now you could stay right here. Another option is to turn the forehead towards the floor and take that top arm and extend it overhead for a little bit deeper stretch. Both are good options. One just might be a better option for you today. Forehead should be resting on something, so either the floor or a block. Hips stay high. Fingertips reach away from the body. Let's go ahead and unravel that, bringing the hand in, lifting off of the bottom arm, taking that to side two, flipping the right palm up, threading it through the right side, starting your traditional, and then decide if you're going to move into that extended, bring the forehead down and top arm up overhead. Continuing to breathe and stretch the fingertips away from the body. Holding here just a few more moments longer. Bring that top arm down. Unwinding a little bit. And then when you're ready, come all the way down onto your belly. We'll bring arms to a goalpost position. We'll creep the right hand up just slightly, think like a half inch or maybe a full inch, not much more. We'll take the left hand, place it under the left shoulder. We'll get into a deep pec stretch here, rolling right over top of that right arm, bringing the leg with us. Feeling a stretch through the front of the shoulder and the chest. For those of you who are in Ignite, did a bunch of push-ups, this should feel pretty necessary. I don't know if good's the right terminology. Take a few more breath cycles here. Let's come back to center. Let's find that goalpost position with the arms again, so 90 degrees in both elbows. Now we'll take the left hand and just creep it up about a half inch to an inch. We'll take the right hand and place it right underneath the shoulder, rolling right over the left arm and bringing our leg with us, getting that deep stretch through the chest and the front of the shoulder, allowing your head to rest on something.
Face to face with the younger me. Face all of the heartbreak. Here's what I do differently.
Coming back to center. Finding our way to our backside. So rolling over. Go ahead and bring the heels and toes together. And let's reach the arms overhead, maybe bringing them together at the top. And then we'll go ahead and walk our feet over to the corner of our mat, off to the left side. And then we'll let our hands follow, also going to the left side, top corner of our mat. And getting a nice side body stretch as your body is shaped like the letter C or a banana. Keeping length in both side bodies so that hands are stretching away from the body as are the feet. Taking a few more big inhales here. Bringing the upper body back to center. Walking the feet over to the center and then take them over to the right side or side two. And then we'll take the upper body over as well. Again, thinking length in both side bodies. So the hands and feet are still reaching away from the body, getting a stretch, especially through the left side body.
The things of earth are tingling. in the light of your glory and grace.
Walking the feet back to center, as well as the upper body. From here, we'll bring our arms down to goalpost or T position. We'll walk our knees in, so bend the knees, break the soles of the feet on the floor, and then pull our knees in towards our chest. And if you want to use your hands to guide them, we'll set the knees down to one side into a side-lying spinal twist. Find a comfortable position with your feet. You might find that bringing the knees up a little bit closer to the chest serves you well. And then turn your knees so that your eyes are going the opposite direction of the knees. Make sure that your head's resting down on something and that your legs are also resting on either the floor or each other.
Big
slowly and carefully, let's walk ourselves back to center and then take that to side two. So arms are in that T position or goalpost. Knees come down to the opposite side. Adjust the legs as needed. Eyes go the opposite direction of the knees. Slowly and carefully untangle yourselves. Do you have a yoga block? We'll use that next as an option. So I'm going to show the one without the yoga block first, and then I'll show with the yoga block. We're going to get into some extension through the spine and the chest. So one option would be to find cactus arms, reach the sternum towards the ceiling and look back. Another option is to take your block. We're going to place it right behind the shoulder blades. And then rest on it, bringing the arms down to the side, extending the legs long if that works for you. So if you get here and you're like, nope, that's not for me, take that seated variation with the cactus arms. With your block, you want it to be kind of right between the shoulder blades, so it opens up the chest. Another option is to take the arms up overhead. That might deepen that opening a little bit. That's the right way to phrase that. Spending a few more moments here. Slowly coming out of it, if arms are overhead, bring them down to your sides. Carefully come up and remove the block. We'll have everybody meet down on your backside. Hug the knees into your chest. Just roll side to side. Either crossing your ankles or rolling to one side, we'll find our way to a seated position. Finding something comfortable. We'll go ahead and finish with two big inhales here at the end. We'll reach our arms up overhead with a big inhale, just from the seated position, big inhale. Open mouth, exhale. One more time, big inhale. And exhale. And that is a wrap, Thursday. Excellent work today. Thank you for making time for you and your mobility. If you have questions for me, stop by and see me on your way out. Virtual, it was so good to have you.
We'll awesome. Thanks, Lynne.
Similar next week with a few additional variations. Control me. I'm so mystic.